This is the day that God has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning and welcome to Zion United Church of Christ here in Union, Missouri for the third Sunday in Advent. Today is a day of joy. Today is a day of hope. Today is a day where we will sing songs and celebrate this wonderful season. We have some special guests here. So I just want to give a little round of applause for our guest musicians, this little quartet. Thank you so much. It is an honor and a delight to have you all here. It's also our Christmas program today. So in just a few minutes after we get rolling into service, we'll be able to have what such a wonderful time with our youth leading today's worship service. So with that, it is time before, oh, that's right, we're doing announcements now, right, during this time. I remember things. So a couple things. Tomorrow, there's a couple deadlines, so we're getting the church newsletter done early, so tomorrow is the deadline. If you want anything for the January newsletter, tomorrow, the 18th, that is when the newsletter articles are due. Similarly, if you want poinsettias ordered, tomorrow is also the deadline for poinsettias. And similarly, as we're looking towards next week, we are having both the fourth Sunday of Advent next Sunday morning at 9 a.m., and then Christmas Eve service at 6:30. So those two services will be different, just to let you know. But otherwise, it's an exciting time. Christmas is almost here. And with that, let us worship God.
Would you please
join me in the call to worship. How does a weary world rejoice? Songs of hope. We allow hope to change us, to strengthen us. We tell the stories of what could be. We listen for God's word. We resist the temptation to give up or give in. We remember Mary's song. We gather for worship. We hope. We hope against all odds. We hope. Friends, this is the day that the Lord is still making. Let us worship our holy God. Let us pray. Loving God, the grass withers and the flowers fade, but your word stands forever. So today we pray. Help us to truly hear it. Allow your words to sink deep into the marrow of our bones. Allow your words to lift up our hearts in hope that we might feel one day closer to your promised day. We believe that hope can change the world. We believe that God uses ordinary people, like an unwed teenage mother, for extraordinary good. And we believe that each of these ordinary people can make a difference. We know that grief, fear, and suffering abound. We know that suffering quells joy and makes it harder to hope. But we choose hope anyway. In the face of hardship, we hope together. We hope with God. We hope for a better world. This is our song. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. The first reading of Scripture comes from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 1, verses 46 through 55. And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowly state of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. Indeed, his mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has come to the aid of his child Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham, and to his descendants forever." Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Thanks be to God. Would you please rise in body or in spirit as you join me in singing our opening hymn, "Come Thou Long Expected Jesus," hymn number 153. Please be seated. Family of faith. We all know that a small group of dedicated people can change the world. That's how it's always been. People like Mary, people like Zechariah, people like John the Baptist. And yet we rarely feel like we can be one of those people. We downplay our ability to make a difference. We choose pessimism over optimism. We sweep hope under the rug for the sake of realism. We forget the words to Mary's song. Fortunately for us, our God carries enough hope and grace for all of us. So let us go to God in prayer. Let us speak the truth of our lives, and let that honesty change us. Please join me in the prayer of confession. Holy God, more days than not, hope feels like the rain. We try to hold on to it with cupped hands, but eventually it slips right on through. Forgive us for holding hope so loosely. Forgive us for allowing the realities of today to define tomorrow. We know that this world needs people of hope, so today we pray. Turn us into those people. Teach us how to sing Mary's song of hope for the world. With open hearts, we pray. Amen. Body of Christ, no matter how many times we let hope slip through our fingers, we still belong to God. So hear and repeat these words after me. I am God's beloved. I am forgiven. I am blessed and sent to serve. This is the good news of the gospel. This is a hope we can hang our hats on. Thanks be to God for God's unending love. Amen. Brothers and sisters, siblings in Christ, it is time to give thanks and glory to God as we dedicate the gifts of both our time, our talent, and our treasure to the ongoing work and ministry of this congregation. We give thanks to all of those who continue to contribute to this mission and ministry here at Zion United Church of Christ. And at this time, would you please rise in body or in spirit and join me in singing the doxology. Was, God who is, God who will be, we give you thanks. We give you thanks for the moments that lead us to this moment of gratitude. We dedicate these gifts presented before you in the good and confident hope we have in you. In your name we pray, amen. You may be seated. The second reading of Scripture comes from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 1, verses 67 through 80. Then his father Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and prophesied, "Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has looked favorably upon his people and redeemed them. He has raised up a mighty Savior for us in the house of his child David, as he spoke through the mouth of his holy prophets from of old, that we would be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all who hate us. Thus he has shown the mercy promised to our ancestors and has remembered his holy covenant, the oath that he swore to our ancestor Abraham, to grant us that we, being rescued from the hand of our enemies, might serve him without fear, in holiness and righteousness, in his presence all our days.
and you, child, will be called the prophet of the Most High. For you will go before the Lord to prepare his ways, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. Because of the tender mercy of our God, the dawn from on high will break upon us, to shine upon those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace. The child grew and became strong in spirit, and he was in the wilderness until the day he appeared publicly to Israel. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Thanks be to God. And at this time, we're going to be beginning our Christmas program, so I invite all of those who are participating to come forward.
Good morning. I'd like to welcome you to our stellar Christmas. Today we're here to celebrate the out-of-this-world way God sent his son Jesus to bring light and life to the world.
Hey kids, last summer you had a blast at Stellar VBS, remember?
Yeah. And since then, you've shined Jesus' light all over your schools, homes, and neighborhoods. Way to go! Grown-ups, let's give all the kids a round of applause.
Kids, you're stars who shine Jesus' light everywhere you go. And now, you're the stars of Stellar Christmas. Together, we'll bring the true meaning of Christmas to light as we remember and tell about the night Jesus was born. But first, let's bring the light of Advent to the room.
All right, I need Nora, Anna. So Nora, you need one, and Anna, you need two, and then as well.
How does a weary world help? By telling stories of hope. By lighting candles in the night. And planting seeds in the winter that will bloom in the spring. By praying for children as they grow and picking up trash on the sidewalk. By insisting that small acts can make a difference. There are a million ways to practice hope. So today we light the candle of hope as a reminder and a charge.
Candles are not the only light in the room. Just look at all of these stars. Kids, you are now the stars twinkling in the night sky when Jesus was born. And tonight, this morning, you'll shine Jesus' light just like we did at VBS this summer.
Now, for the grown-ups in the room, you need to know something. Throughout our time this morning, you'll hear 5 special Bible points. When you hear the Bible points, everyone will shout out these words, "Shine Jesus' light." Try that with me now. Shine Jesus' light.
Seems like you might need a little extra help. Fear not, that's why we have these starry hosts over here. When you see the kids and me fling out our fingers like this, that'll be your cue to say, "Shine Jesus' light." It's like you have twinkle hands, you got it? Shine Jesus' light. Wow, you're superstars, nicely done. Now, let's get this Christmas celebration started, shall we? First up are our tiniest stars. Please welcome our preschool starlets. Any preschoolers that are still outing there and want to participate, now is your time to come on forward and sit on these front steps. All right, preschoolers, will you wave to everyone out there? Can you wave? Preschoolers, wave. Yeah, good job. Our littlest stars shine Jesus' light in an extra special way. Preschoolers learned a special song to the tune of "Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star." Starlets, will you sing that for us now? Thank you, preschool starlets. Let's give them a hand. Preschoolers, it's time for you to sparkle back and sit with your families again. Parents of preschools, will you stand and shine some of your Jesus light with your fingers so that's easy for them to find you? All right, the rest of you, we're going to let you stay sitting down for a bit because we don't want to have any falling stars during this program. It's time to introduce our Bible memory buddies. They're members of the heavenly host who welcomed Jesus to our planet on that first Christmas.
Let's welcome these celestial beings.
All right, first, we have Cosmo the star. Cosmo, in your clearest and most sparkling voice, please say, "Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine."
Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Everybody clap for Cosmo.
Then there's Ringo the planet. See the rings go round? Ringo, give that hula hoop a little spin around your waist and say, "Yeah, yeah, yeah."
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Ooh la la, it's Luna the moon. Luna's just beaming with excitement. Luna, shine your biggest and brightest smile.
Luna, stand on up. Shine your biggest smile.
Next we have Sol, the sun. Soul is our sunshine, our sunshine soul. Can you move your hula hoop in a circle and let it shine for all of us?
And last but not least, it's Haley the comet. Haley loves to orbit. Haley spins in a circle 3 times and say, "Hey, hey, hey."
Hey, hey, hey.
Cosmo, you'll help us get this Christmas story started. So step right up here, and everybody else, have a seat.
Did you know that a lot of stars like Cosmo are even bigger and brighter than the sun? They shine through the darkness from really far away to remind us that when life feels dark, shine Jesus' light.
Oh, let's try that again. When life feels dark,
shine Jesus' light.
You're supposed to stand right here.
The world felt dark before Jesus came. Jesus is the light of the world because he shows God's love and forgiveness to everyone. Before Jesus came, there was a bright star shining in the sky. Let's sing the first Noel as we remember that light. We will sing verses 1, 2, and 4 of hymn 229.
Really need Jesus right now. Ringo, will you come up and help us tell why we need Jesus light?
Yeah.
This is Ringo, a planet. Ringo, give your ring a little spin around your waist again. Ringo's rings may look like one piece, but they're actually made up of billions of chunks of rock and ice. The rock and ice stick together instead of breaking apart. Ringo's rings remind us that it's good for people to stick together too, and that when people don't get along, shine Jesus' light.
People weren't always getting along, so well before Jesus was born, a nation called Rome had taken over everything. The Romans in charge didn't really care about God's people. Rome just wanted to be big and great.
Congregation, we need your help. Pretend you're in the Roman army. Everyone make muscles and say, "We're big and great."
Well, in order to pay for these big, grand Roman collected money for all of the people, gotta love taxes. Joseph and Mary have to pay Rome taxes too. Here they are now.
God chose them to be Jesus' parents on earth. They're on their way to Bethlehem to pay taxes because that was Joseph's family's hometown.
Mary and Joseph traveled all the way to Bethlehem. Let's read this part from the Bible.
From Luke chapter 2, verses 4 through 7. And because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village Nazareth in Galilee. He took with him Mary, who he was engaged, who was now expecting a child. And while they were there, the time came for a baby to be born. She gave birth to a firstborn son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of clothing and laid him in a manger because there was no lodging available for them.
Yes, the silent stars shone in the Bethlehem sky to celebrate the special child, God's son, Jesus. It all happened in a little town called Bethlehem. Everyone, let's sing hymn 180, verses 1, 2, and 4.
Talk about a good thing. Jesus was born. Let's hear our next Bible point from Luna.
It's Luna, the Earth's moon. Luna sure can brighten up the night sky with that smile. Luna, show us that dazzling smile again. Luna doesn't make light, but simply reflects the good light the sun is shining. That reminds us that when good things happen, shine Jesus's light.
God wanted people to know about this good news, so he sent a special message. I'll tell you what happened. But first, we'll need shepherds.
Need shepherds. All right, shepherds, come
Hi, shepherds, give everyone a wave.
We need an angel. It's your turn. Give us a wave, angel.
Now, congregation, we'll need your help for the other two parts. First, you'll be a flock of sheep. When you hear the word sheep, baa as loud as you can for 5 seconds. Give it a try. Ready? Go.
Great. Next, you'll be the heavenly... You'll be the heavenly host that joins the angels. When you hear glory, lift your hands to the roof and praise God like this. Join me. Lift both hands like you're raising the roof and say, glory to God. I think you're ready.
That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Look, there they are now. Shepherds, please walk up and down the center aisle with your sheep. Those sheep are too cute. Congregation, can you change that?
That was bad. Want to try again?
Better. Angel, it's your time to shine. Stand up nice and tall, throw your hands up in the air, and say, ta-da.
Ta-da.
Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. Angel, give us another good ta-da.
Ta-da.
The shepherds were startled. Show us your startled faces, shepherds. They were scared. Show how you crouch down on the ground when you're scared, shepherds.
Crouch down, shepherds. You're scared. You're scared.
The shepherds gasped with fear. What, did you hear them? I think it was louder than that. Everyone, gasp like you're terrified, then hold your breath.
The shepherds were terrified, but the angel said,
don't be afraid.
Whew. Everyone, let out your breath with relief. Just for fun, angel, give us one more ta-da.
Ta-da.
The angel said,
the Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David.
Angel, just so you're clear, go ahead and point toward Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus. They are.
The angel told the shepherds they'd find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth, lying in a manger. So cute.
Suddenly, the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying, glory. Audience, that's your cue. Raise the roof and say, glory to God. I said glory. Audience, lift hands and say, glory to God, again.
Glory to God.
One more time, glory. Audience, lift hands and say, glory.
What a day. If you're able, let's stand and celebrate the light and life that Jesus brings with us with hymn 185.
Thank you.
good day. When good things happen,
shine Jesus' light.
When good things happen,
shine Jesus' light.
All right, next we're going to read what the shepherds did next.
Luke chapter 2, verses 15 through 16. When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds had said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see the thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." They hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was a baby lying in the manger.
You heard right, shepherds. Hurry on over to Mary and Joseph to meet baby Jesus.
I'm not sure how long they hung out with baby Jesus. Maybe until the sun came up the next day? Speaking of the sunrise, Sol, move on over here. Everyone have a seat while Sol the sun shines on us. Shepherds, have a seat. Ooh, shiny.
Sol is the earth's sun. Sol's sunny rays can bring cheer on the saddest of days. Which reminds me, when people are sad, shine Jesus' light.
You see, Jesus is a gift for everyone. Because Jesus was born, he knows what it's like to be human.
Jesus knows what it's like to laugh until your sides hurt. Everyone, laugh a jolly old laugh.
Jesus knows how it feels to see a good friend. Go ahead and give someone beside you a little shoulder squeeze or a high five and say, "Hi, friend."
Yes, Jesus knows all about the good stuff about being human. And Jesus also knows sad stuff, too.
Jesus knows what it's like to cry and have a headache. Jesus knows what it's like to say goodbye to people we love. Let's all hold our heads like we have a headache and think of those sad times in our life.
Jesus, God's one and only Son, entered our sadness in order to bring us life and hope. He gave up everything, including his life, in order to show God's love.
Jesus, for this is how God loved the world. He gave his one and only Son.
So that everyone who believes in him.
Everyone believes in him.
Will
not perish,
life.
But have a eternal life.
Through Jesus, the God of the stars showed how much he loves people, including each one of you. Let's share this news with everyone by singing "Go Tell It on the Mountain," hymn 218.
Thank you.
Let's praise. Let's all close our eyes so all we see is darkness. God of the stars, we thank you that your love and care for us, even though we're sad. Jesus, right now we pause to think about things in our lives that make us sad this Christmas. Now, let's open our eyes to see the light around us as we end our prayer. Jesus, just as light shines in this room, may your light shine in our hearts, bringing hope and peace, and may your light shine through us, sharing your joy with others. Amen.
Let's hear from our last buddy, is Hallie the Comet. Hallie, come on forward.
Hallie is a comet. Hallie races around space in huge orbits, passing a lot of planets along the way. Hallie, will you orbit around this room for us? Run all the way around everyone in this room. Everyone, help out by cheering Hallie on. Hallie, on your mark, get set, go. Phew. When you're running around, don't forget to look for people in need. When people need help, Shine Jesus' light.
The shepherds needed help telling people about Jesus. Shepherds, are you ready?
No.
You have one more job. The shepherds, you guys are all going to race back to Bethlehem. So go on back there. Race to Bethlehem. So the shepherds raced to Bethlehem, and they took Jesus' light with them. Hallie, you need to go around and race with them. Where'd you go? All right, shepherds, come on back up. The shepherds told everyone what had happened. Their lights shone brightly for Jesus, and so can yours.
All right, joyful noise.
Thank you.
That was wonderful, joyful noise. Will you come take a seat? Well, folks, this has been a stellar Christmas. Thanks for shining Jesus' light right here at Zion. Let's thank the stars of Stellar Christmas for leading this morning. Congregation, give them a round of applause. We need to shout, shine Jesus' light one more time. So everywhere we go, thank you, everyone. For those of you who wore your mismatched socks, please help us shine some light for Jake. At the end of the worship service, we're going to come right up here and take a photo. If you forgot to wear mismatched socks, talk to your neighbor. They might be able to help you out. Good morning. Thank you. Shine Jesus' light.
In the spirit of prayer. God of today and tomorrow, we take a deep breath in and fill our lungs with you, for we know you are here, present with us as we pray. We know that you are listening, so with gratitude, we continue to hear the songs of today ringing in our hearts. We understand that some days, just as you have to sing gratitude for what exists, sing praise for what could be. Today we follow in Mary's footsteps, and we start with gratitude. So we thank you, Creator God, for filling our days with beautiful things like candlelight and freshly baked bread, evergreen trees, family dinners, creases in a good book, the children who continue to show us the way. We have so much to be grateful for, and so we sing songs of praise. However, we know that Mary did not only sing in response to your goodness. We know Mary also sang for the future of your goodness. Her song was a song of protest, a song of declaring what the world could be, would be, should be. So today, holy God, we also bring you prophetic prayers of hope. Turn injustice on its head, lift up the poor and hungry, comfort the sick and the aching, tend the lonely and the lost, and then plant a fire in our hearts to do the same. For we know that you are here. We know that you are present with us as we pray. We know that you join our voices as we sing. So together we take one step closer to your kingdom by joining our voices with the words your Son taught us to pray. Together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Would you please rise in body or in spirit and join me in our closing hymn, hymn number 179, verses 1, 2, and 4, Joy to the World.
Thank you.
have you sit down, actually. Receive this benediction. Family of faith, as you leave this place, you go into a weary world. So speak tenderly. Do the good that is yours to do. Choose connection. Hold on to hope. And remember that Christ took on flesh for you. You are God's beloved. So go rejoicing. The world needs it. Amen and amen.